Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Demosthenes. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you, Philip. Philip, my best friend and the greatest of the Hellenes I know, who worked for our causes for basically his whole life, who spent millions of dollars to see justice for Cyprus and a better Greek nation for us and a better Greek American community, we thank you. And we thank Chrysoula, his wife, who also for 4 years stood next to him. Thank you, Philip. A big round of applause for Philip. Your Eminence, dear honored guests, dear friends, απόψε εδώ, λοιπόν, μέσα σε αυτή τη φιλόξενη αίθουσα λαμβάνουμε την τιμητική διάκριση, τη διάκριση του Φιδιππιδίου βραβείου, όλοι μαζί. Δεν είμαι άνθρωπος ούτε των βραβείων, ούτε των υπερβολών, ούτε της πολυσυνάφειας του κόσμου, όπως λέει ο ποιητής Καβάφης. Ανταποκρίθηκα στο κάλεσμα του πολιτιστικού οργανισμού GAEPIS, πρώτα για να σεβαστώ την ευγενική αυτή πρόταση και δεύτερον να τιμήσω και εγώ με τη σειρά μου μια ελληνική φωνή της ομογένειας που για 29 τώρα χρόνια φωνάζει και αγωνίζεται για την Ελλάδα, την Κύπρο, τη γλώσσα μας και τον ελληνισμό. Σας ευχαριστώ ειλικρινά για την ξεχωριστή αυτή η τιμή. Επίσης ευχαριστώ τον Πρόεδρο Κώστα Αγγελούδη, το Συμβούλιο και όλους τους εθελοντές του προγράμματος. Επίσης θέλω να ευχαριστήσω τη γυναίκα μου, Κάρολ, και την κόρη μου Αριάννα, για την αγάπη τους στη συμπαράσταση και υπομονή που μου έδειξαν για τόσα χρόνια. Είμαι ένας από τους ανθρώπους που πιστεύουν στη δύναμη της ελληνικής ψυχής. Ένας απλός στρατιώτης, μια μονάδα αυτής της ποθητής ομάδας, η οποία θα μπορούσε να αποτελέσει την πιο ισχυρή γροθιά ανάμεσα στον ελληνισμό της Αμερικής και της απανταχού διασποράς. Μια γροθιά που θα μπορούσε πραγματικά να βοηθήσει την κοινότητα μας εδώ, την Ελλάδα και την Κύπρο. Dear friends, we are here tonight to receive this honor, the Phidippidean award, all of us together. I'm not someone who likes to receive awards and accolades. Many of you know that I'm just a proud member of our community, like all of us. I accepted this award from the cultural organization GAEPIS, first to show respect to them for honoring me with this very prestigious award, and in turn for me to honor GAEPIS, the Greek voice of our community, which for 29 years is fighting for us, our language, Greece, and Cyprus. I thank you for this very special honor. I also like to take this opportunity to thank my wife, Carol, and daughter, Ariana, for their love, for standing behind me in all these years, for their patience. Thank you. I'm one who strongly believes in the spirit of the Greek, in the power of the Greek spirit. A plain soldier, a single unit in a desired group, which could ultimately become a powerful force in our community the diaspora, Greece, and Cyprus. I've been here for 50 years. As so many of us become very successful in whatever we choose to do. Be it a professional, an academic, an entrepreneur, a scientist, someone in politics. A single unit, we thrive. Our community rates first in education and second in wealth amongst the different groups in this country and nationalities. Sadly, though, in these 50 years, I noticed a decline in the organized groups of the Omogenia. Our federations, our Somatia, are threatened with extinction. They cannot attract our youth, our amazing young professionals. We did not manage to change our ways. Our church, with all the efforts of our eminence, Archbishop Iakovos, Dimitrios, I'm sorry, of all our hierarchs, is declining and its membership is diminishing. Without institutions and organized groups, a society and a community disappear. We face existential threats. In the 50 years, I noticed the decline of Greece and Cyprus. These amazing people in these two countries unfortunately allowed people to lead them, where most of them were not leaders, but crooks and opportunists. Thus, Greece and Cyprus are facing existential threats as well. Why is our church and other organized groups diminishing, and how can we help? Why don't we have more influence in Washington when, as the Jews and others showed us, it is possible? Why do we only have 7-8 Greek charter schools and not hundreds like the Turks do? Why are we not able to help Greeks and Cyprus in a very meaningful way? And I'm not discounting the 4-5 million we send for philanthropic purposes. Why can we not help Greece and Cyprus become global forces in the food industry, when the Greek and Mediterranean diets are in everybody's mind? Why can we not help Greece become the premium destination in cultural, medical, religious, and fun tourism? Why can we not help the young entrepreneurs with amazing technologies finance their startups and bring them to the world markets? I can go on and on. But I know and I believe deep in my heart that we can do all these things and do them well. We can do all these things if we first recognize that our Achilles heel as a people is our desire to do things as individuals. And sometimes do things collectively, but on a voluntary basis. And I'm not against voluntarism. It is very important. But unfortunately, this never worked to our advantage. It will not help us survive and thrive as Hellenes. The Jews recognized this many years ago and decided that they would let professionals lead them in their community affairs. They donated and donate continuously a lot of money to organize as American Jewish Committee, as IPAC, Jewish federations, and all sorts of institutions. AJC alone has 2,500 employees, $80 million worth of a budget every year, 29 offices in different countries. Institutions which enable them to become so strong as a community that can influence policies in Washington, locally and globally, and in Israel. Dear friends, it's very easy to say how much we love our community, to say how much we love Greece and Cyprus. We can sing our love for Greece from the four corners of the globe. At some point, though, the need for real and helpful actions become necessary. Theories and wishful thinking are not enough to correct our mistakes and non-involvement for the common good. These 3.5 years ago, I decided to help find HALC, the Hellenic American Leadership Council, a professional organization run by paid professionals to address some of our community's challenges. In 3 short years, with only 3-4 people on staff, few amazing members, young Greek professionals who are here now today, a lot of them, doctors, lawyers, judges, entrepreneurs, and people in Washington, and these are our HALC members, with 55,000 followers on Facebook, we created one of the most effective Greek organizations in the country. For the first time, our community can send letters to the president with 35,000 signatures. Before, the most we got was 800 to 1,000. We created the Greek-Israeli caucus in Congress, a great alliance to help us with the American government and the politicians. We have a great alliance with AJC, a powerful organization, the Armenians, African American organization, Kurdish organizations, alliances needed for a small community. We had events in Congress as to how to help Greece. Our members hold fundraisers in different states to raise funds and encourage our community to vote for politicians, something that gives us access to power locally and nationally, and that is important. We are organizing, as we speak, an academic registry of Greek professors and students nationally at different universities. This brain power will hopefully help us revive our community, influence academia favorably towards our community and causes, as well as influence think tanks and the media. Imagine if there were lectures by experts once a month in your community that you would be interested in. Imagine if there was a night of poetry or a cultural event in your not so often used church hall. Wouldn't most of us go there? Imagine if we were able to have our business people, our entrepreneurs and professionals talk to our young as to how to start a business, get a job or internships. Wouldn't the young go to the Kritikos Spiti or the Pansiprian to be helped in this way? Of course they would. We can do all these things once we have the paid professional people to handle and execute all these very doable things. It takes a lot of money, but it can be done. It can be done. It can never be done on a voluntary basis. In this past summer, HALC, in just 50 hours, matched a $50,000 challenge from the Jaharis Foundation, and then another $50,000 challenge for the total amount of $235,000 in 2 weeks, which went to the SOS Greek village to help few hundred orphans who stay there from the age of 2 to 18, and after that, help to go to college. I do not believe that this could be done without the way HALC has been organized, without the dedication of our young and very successful members. A lot of them are here tonight, and we thank you. And these are the future leaders of our community, which with new ideas and new ways will make us thrive if we can sustain them within our hold. Thank you again. We can do it. We are the people who came here with nothing, but the desire to work very hard, to get an education, earn money, and do better in life. We can do it, but first we have to accept and recognize the fact that no matter how high we got in our business or profession, or whatever station in life we occupy, we did not get there only by our own efforts, smarts, or hard work. We got there because we were able to step and stand on the shoulders of others. The shoulders of our parents, our teachers, our friends, our village, our Hellenic roots. We owe it to our Philodemo, which should be our guiding post, to our forefathers like Pericles, who said that it is not the monuments that we leave behind that are important, but what is important, it is how many lives we touched. Knowing that, then, it is an obligation for all of us to help in each and every way we can, selflessly. None of us will take money with us. But believe me, the $10, the $50, the $10,000, whatever it is, helping our community create institutions and professional organizations is a worthy cause. This is the only way it can be done. And we can do it. We are the people that the whole world took our knowledge from in science, philosophy, democratic values, theater, the arts, so that they could advance. We are the people that, although very few, kept the Persian invaders out of Europe. We are the only people that, along with Russia, for the Germans and fascism on our own soil. Many praised us by saying that Greeks not fight like heroes, but that heroes fight like Greeks. We are the people who said, Ochi. We are the people that, although few, very few, who have many Nobel laureates. We are the people that when we come together, we can achieve miracles, and we can. Nothing is impossible. Everything is possible when we believe in it and work for it. Η πατρίδα θέλει αγάπη. Μερικές φορές η αγάπη δεν αρκεί να είναι μόνο ευχή. Η αγάπη χρειάζεται δουλειά πολύ. και υπομονή και πείσμα και μεθοδικότητα. Ένας φίλος μου έστειλε τους στίχους του Οδυσσέα Λύτη. Ένα το χελιδόνι και η άνοιξη ακριβή. Για να γυρίσει ο ήλιος θέλει δουλειά πολύ. Θέλει νεκροί χιλιάδες να είναι στους τροχούς. Θέλει και οι ζωντανοί μας να δίνουν το αίμα τους. Ευχαριστώ.